Welcome to the Filament Basics video guide. In this guide, we will be covering the basic techniques and procedures when handling filament for your Raise3D machine. This video will be a general guide and will not be covering specific material settings or advanced techniques. If you are experiencing difficulty with setup or would like assistance with an advanced procedure, contact our support team by visiting help.raise3d.com. Loading. Install your spool holders onto these designated mounting points located behind the side door. Place your filament on the spool holder and feed the filament end up through the corresponding guide tube. Pay careful attention to the direction of the spools. Note that the filament spools should always feed towards the center. Lift the guide tube out of the printhead and release a length of filament from the end. Insert the filament completely into the printhead. Open the Utilities tab on your touchscreen and lower the bed position. In the Filament Loader section of the touchscreen, identify the nozzle that you will be loading. Verify that the temperature for that nozzle is set for your material type. For Raise3D PLA, this temperature is 215 degrees Celsius. Note, this temperature may vary if you have previously unloaded a different material type. Refer to the Loading for Different Material Types section of this video if this is the case for your unit. Select Load to begin the desired process. The printer automatically begins heating to the proper temperature. Once that temperature is reached, a Load button will appear. Select the Load button and allow your printer to automatically feed. If the printer did not catch the filament, gently guide it until the gear grabs hold of the filament strand. Allow the filament to continue loading until the material extrudes evenly. Press OK to complete the loading process. Discard the excess extrusion. Unloading. To unload filament, open the Utilities tab and verify that the bed is lowered at least 60 millimeters below the origin point. Under the Filament Loader section, select the Unload button. Similar to the loading procedure, the printer will automatically heat to the target temperature. Once the temperature is achieved, the Unload button will become available. Select Unload. The printer will preload by ejecting the remaining filament from the hot end, then unload the remaining strand. When the filament has completed retracting, select OK. Wind the remaining material back into the filament spool. Keep track of the material end and carefully tuck it into the openings on your filament spool to keep it neat and secure. If the filament end is let loose, this may create tangles in your spool which can cause print failures. Tangles will need to be removed if this is the case. For best results, store your spool in its original plastic with a packet of desiccant. Detangling. Filament spools can become tangled if a filament end has been let loose within the spool. To untangle your spool, locate the tangled coils and create slack underneath them. Slide these coils over the edge of the spool until only a single strand connects the two sections. Wind the remaining material back onto the spool and secure the end into the available slots. Loading for different material types. Loading procedures may require a different temperature from the recommended range when changing between material types. In this example, we'll be unloading ABS and loading PLA. Unloading procedures will remain unchanged. Unload your material using its standard recommended settings. For Raise3D ABS, this temperature is 240 degrees Celsius. When loading a filament that requires a different temperature than your previous material, it is always advised to load with the highest loading temperature. In this case, ABS requires 240 degrees Celsius, while PLA requires 215 degrees Celsius. So, we will be using ABS loading temperatures for the PLA. Set your temperature and select the Load button. Allow your printer to heat up to the proper temperature. Heating to the higher temperature will allow any particles that did not get removed by the preloading to be extruded from the nozzle. Removing these small particles is an essential step to prevent clogging that can cause print failures. When the printer reaches the proper temperature, select Load and allow it to extrude for a longer period of time to ensure all the excess material has been removed. select OK, and remove the excess material.